Next up, we have Junhua Jiang from here at ISTC. He's a senior research engineer at ISTC and a division of the Prairie Research Institute here at U of I. And he is going to tell us about supercapacitor developments.
Good afternoon, everyone. And the title of my presentation is Progress of Biochar Supercapacitors. We introduced our supercapacitor, Biochar supercapacitor work a few times last year at our Illinois Biochar group meeting. Today, we'll report our new progress. And first, I would like to thank ISTC management team and staffs, but I can't list all of the names. Nancy gives her consistent support for this work, and I would like to mention one story. Our IT officer at DASO brought us lots of wooders from his yard. Some of them works really good. And we got support from Illinois Hazard Waste Research Fund. It allows us to do a little bit systematic work. I need to thank our collaborators, Dr. Lei Zhang and Professor Frank Chen at the University of South Carolina. Duo Dang, she's sitting over there in this room. And also would like to thank staff at Beckman Institute Material Research Lab and ISGS for their assistance doing experiments. Traditionally, supercapacitors are widely used for electric vehicles, devices and telecom communication systems. Today, there are two important emerging markets. One is for transportation, another is for energy storage. Why supercapacitors are interesting for electric vehicles and energy storage? This diagram shows the position of supercapacitors. They fill the gap between traditional capacitors and the batteries. We know high performance batteries and fuel cells are two primary candidates for electric vehicles, but they normally are limited to provide constant power. We need supercapacitors on board to provide instant power. From here, we can see that the capacitors has very high power density. And for energy storage, supercapacitors can beat any other energy storage technology. They're located at the corner of this diagram. It's a lot difficult for supercapacitors to achieve around 100% efficiency and around 100,000 cycles. Currently, the market of supercapacitors is small. We can see that in 2010, the total market value is around $0.5 billion. But this is quickly changing during two driving forces. One is electric vehicle, another is energy storage station. And we expect and the market could reach around $5 billion in the next 10 years. For large-scale application of supercapacitance, cost is the primary consideration. And for the production, the cost, 60% comes from the materials. Similar to the batteries, supercapacitors uses four components, this packing, separator, electrode, and electrolyte. Among the four components, the material cost material is the biggest cost contributor. Its portion is around 50%. So it's very important to decrease electrode cost. Why biochar is interesting for supercapacitor applications? It's quite likely to get a low cost the biochar as at around $0.1 per kilogram. This price is much lower than the price of today's low-cost activated carbon, and its cost is around $5 per kilogram. We would like to back to this chart. If we can replace activated carbon with biochar, so probably we can decrease this portion to around 1%. So that's very attractive. But for supercapacitors electrode, there is additional requirements on biochars. The biochar must have excellent chemical and electrochemical stability. Also, the biochar must have good conductivity and also the high utilization of surface areas. For high carbon with zero ash, will be ideal for electrode application. And actually, we achieved that. This EDX spectrum shows the major carbon pattern and the minor oxygen pattern. And the carbon content is very high. It's around 98%. The oxygen this content actually for super capacitor application is useful. Another primary requirement for biochar supercapacitance is good conductivity. We can see that we can get the biochar has around 1 to 50 these values. They are quite comparable with other commercial carbon materials. Why this value is wider open, we can understand in this equation, because this conductivity is dependent on the porosity. Different biochar has different porosities. And also, we can increase the conductivity of biochar by controlling temperature. So normally, the higher the temperature, the higher the conductivity. Activated carbon has been widely used for supercapacitor application because they have a very special porous structure. Activated carbon, they have a microporous with a pore size around 50 nanometer, and the mesoporous pore size between 2 to 50 nanometer, and the microporous, the pore size less than 2 nanometers. From this transmission line equivalent circle, we can see the porous utilization is also dependent on the electrolyte resistance. The normally increase the porous depth, so we increase the electrolyte resistance that decrease the porous utilization. And for the electrode with multiple pores, we can use a single capacitor to represent one single pore. And the total capacitance will come from the all the contribution of all the pores utilized. And because the porous structure is very important for supercapacitors electrode performance. So we use several techniques to study the microstructure for biochar prepared from different feedstocks. First, we use X-ray CT to study its inside structure. This is a lay-by-lay structure. This one lay will show us, we can see this mesh-like porous structures. And I also got a very beautiful image. Oh, sorry. Yeah, some video, something like that. Could we play that? Yes. It's this one. Oh, could you please go to the front page of the previous one? And, we got very beautiful 3D images. So if you have used them for the way, I can show you later. And it's on. Okay, and this is the CT images for that cone pitch part. So we can see, mesh like the structure as well, and the difference is this opening is bigger. This cannot be seen from SEM image. So I think this CT tactic is very powerful to see the inside structure. And we also prepared the biochars from softwood. And here we can see this softwood has a fingerprint porous structure. This regular microporous zone, this carbon walls between these two pores actually are very thin. It's interesting, we can see this marker pores are separated by some boundary zones. And they also have a porous structure, difference that pores stretched and squeezed. And from the side view, we can see this parent line that's porous. And actually, they are interconnected. We can see that there's an interconnected channel. So this structure is important for high surface utilization. We also prepared the biochar from the hardwood. The hardwood has a totally different structure. And there are several kinds of macro pores. This pores is huge, around 200 microns. That's the macro pores with a pore size around 50 and lots of regular pores, pore size around 2 nanometers. From the side view, we can see these large pipes that correspond to these large pores. And also, we can see some connection between the pore structures. Because we got the biochars, one that's question, could we directly use raw biochar as supercapacitor electrodes? The answer is we can. We got the typical response of these supercapacitors. Using the biochar supercapacitors without any treatment. We use the high scan rate. That means this supercapacitor has a faster charging, discharging behavior. And we scan this potential and the current response for 5,000. There's no any performance decay. So that means this raw biochar supercapacitance has good lifetime. And because we didn't use any chemicals and also didn't use additional energy to activate the biochar electrode, I think this is interesting. So this biochar supercapacitors, raw biochar supercapacitors, we found some applications, especially for large scale, for example, energy storage. But their capacity is low, limited around 10 to 20 farad per gram. And that capacity is too low for electric vehicle and electric devices application. So we would like to further increase the capacities of biochar electrodes. The two strategies, the first one, we can increase the surface areas and increase the utilization of the surface. And a lot of strategy actually on biochar surface, there's so many oxygen, that's groups. This acid group, running out of that's power. Thanks. With one oxygen and two oxygen, and basic groups in different forms, this carton, parents, actually, these oxygen groups are involved in charging and discharging process. We call this capacitance from the reaction of surface groups to the capacitance as a pseudo capacitance. Different oxygen group has different electrochemical activities. The quinol and anthracene have the highest activity, but normally it's difficult to achieve this kind of surface groups. And the last activity groups that's related to cation and carbonium, and their electrochemical reduction and reduction and oxidation quite reversible. So they can provide a reasonable charge and discharge reversibility. And the electrochemical activity related to carbonic acid is poor. So normally that peak is widely separated. So our objective is try to increase the surface groups of cations and carbonium. In this presentation, we just introduce the simplest approach to activate the biochar. We use nitric acid to activate the biochar. We can see the big difference. This black line corresponds to the raw biochar electrode, and the red line corresponds to the acid treated the biochar. The response, the red line, is much higher than the black response. That means this nitric acid treatment is very efficient. And this big difference, we can also see there are constant current charge and discharge behavior. And this linear potential and time relation is another typical response of supercapacitors. And for acidic treated biochar, response is much lower because they have higher capacities. And this change is similar to the water level change in a water tank. The higher the tank capacity, the lower the water level decrease or change. Into understand the changes of soil chemistries, we use Raman and FTIR to detect the surface function groups. In this Raman spectrum, we can see this pattern correspond to a diamond band, and this pattern corresponds graphite band. We can use the ratio of the intensity of a diamond bond to the intensity of a graphite to judge the surface disorder. The normally, the higher the ratio, the higher the surface disorder. From here, we can see that this ratio for the acid treatment is higher. So what's responsible for this change? So we use FTIR to further detect surface function group. We can see some new peaks. This peak corresponds to the cations, and this peak corresponds to carbonium. So they are responsible for the capacity increase. We summarized our results in this table and also compared them with those of commercial carbon materials. For our activated carbon, the capacity ranges from 100 to 300 Faraday per grams. So these values is compared to commercial carbon black and also those of activated carbons. The little bit higher than those of advanced carbon materials. Please notice our BET surface areas is much lower than those of commercial and advanced carbon materials. This means our biochar materials has higher surface utilization. And we make a rough estimation, so the utilization degree of our biochar electrode is around 30 to 100%. So high BET surface area is useful, but there are a lot of definitely required. Our biochar electrode probably has optimized porous structure. We also make some estimation. If we can fully utilize this porous surface area, so probably we can achieve around 400 Faraday per gram this capacity. Okay, so also studied our biochar electrode in organic electrolyte. So we can see our biochar performances in organic electrode is comparable to those of commercial carbon materials, but probably we need to develop a different strategy to further increase the capacities. and finally, we can reach our conclusions that Biochar has a fingerprint microstructure inherited from their pre-spontaneous Biochar precursors. And low ash and even zero ash high carbon could be prepared from the wood feedstocks. Biochar capacitors have demonstrated very promising capacities and durabilities, which can comparable to those of advanced carbon materials, especially in these aqueous solutions. And the woody biochars with very high surface area, good conductivity, electrochemical stability, and very interesting the porous structure, as well be promising and energy and environmental materials. And thank you for attention.